I was so pissed off with her that I said, what's the use of having you as a mother? I wish Hema Malini was my mother. At least I'd get a Kent water purifier free.
Yeah. Wonderful title. It has amazing subtext. And I read the book and it resonates right through the narrative. Now, before I opened the book, and of course I read the first couple of pages before I did, and I read that you've dedicated this book to your mom. Now, how come? Now, I know we all dedicate things to our parents, but in this case, I know there's a reason. That's why I'm asking, because, you know, it's all about loving your parents.
No, it's not about loving my parents. And in fact, she's surprised I dedicated this book to her because she never encouraged me in anything. She's always tried to pick faults. Right in the beginning, when I first started writing columns, one of my columns became very popular. And I called her up and I said, Mom, you know, my column is really doing well. Have you read it? And she said, no, but I wanted to tell you over dinner last night that none of your serving dishes match. So I was so pissed off with her that I said, what's the use of having you as a mother? I wish Hema Malini was my mother. At least I'd get a Kent water purifier free.
Yeah.
But on a serious note, when I look back and everything that I write about, it seems to be about women finding their place in the world, about the chafing between what a woman is and what she's meant to be. And somewhere, where is my mother?
Yeah.
And she doesn't know this story, but I think somewhere it's because I have this singular image in my head. When we were little and we moved to our grandmother's house, we all had to share a room. So my mother and my aunt would share the bed, and my sister and me had mattresses on the floor. And every morning at 5, my mom would wake up. She would put on this Jane Fonda tape. She'd put it on mute, and she would do her workout all around it. And then she would go to work. At that time, they used to do 3 shifts. And she'd come home at 9. She never complained. She always had a smile. And for me, I think it was very clear at that point that a woman doesn't have to rely on anyone besides herself. And that men were okay. It was, you know, enjoyable to have them, like a dessert. But they were certainly not the main course. Mm. And
well, we differ, but anyway.
Yeah, well, yeah. I think for you also, they're dessert, definitely not the main course. But
anyway.
Having said that, I think that's pretty much defined my whole life, because I had this unique vantage point looking up from this mattress at this creature in a pink leotard with matching sweatbands. And she set the bar so high that I've spent my whole life reaching for it. So that's why this book and everything else I've written should be dedicated to her.
That's wonderful.